Let's now speak to Professor Milswami Annadurai, former director of the ISRO Satellite Center. So thanks for speaking to NewsX. What, according to you, is India hoping to achieve with Chandrayaan 2?
Chandrayaan 1 is a prime objective, is consolidate what is the discovery of Chandrayaan 1 has done. Chandrayaan 1, you know that it has made a unique discovery which other missions could not make it, lunar missions could not make, discovery of water on the moon, especially that contention is more towards the poles. And especially the South Pole is a region where we expect the more fertile in terms of resources, water and other things, and the possible region where the human habitat can happen. So towards that, I think the South Pole region, we are soft landing. So even though many nations would have landed moon, South Pole is a unique, which is basically driven by the discovery of Chandrayaan 1. And probably in the, for the future point of view, the human habitat, that means return to the moon, possible human habitat, we are talking about that. That's going to happen in the South Pole, near South Pole. And in that case, India will be the first nation to be placed a system, man-made system, near that area.
Do you believe this is ISRO's most complex mission yet?
Yeah, to the date, I think you look at here always, you go over the challenges of incremental improvements from Chandrayaan 1, uniquely polar orbit acquiring is a challenge, and making a Mangalyaan mission around the Mars is becoming a historical feat, the first attempt succeeding. Similarly, this mission is another dimension in the graduation with respect to space exploration point of view. Softly landing on the moon in an identified place, especially we are talking about between the two craters in the near the South Pole, high latitudes in the southern region. So that way, autonomously, a system has to go on land on the moon and ensure minimum of 2 weeks, both soft landed lander of Vikram and the six-wheeled robotic system of a rover named Pragyan able to survive, and as well as do in situ analysis of chemical mineral composition of the moon to understand the origin evolution of the moon, and to consolidate the discovery of Chandrayaan 1. So that way, the last few minutes of its mission before landing is going to be very, very crucial. The things have to be going autonomously, using the onboard autonomy, the sensors, the actuators, which should be, which keep adjusting the speed in which it's going, the direction in which it's going, such that identify a safe region to land, and land it safely with the four legs as stable as possible, and enable the rover to move around its own, within that its technical capabilities, and ensure the whole findings, whatever is done, being beamed back to the earth, so that the scientists on the ground are able to acquire the new and unique, possible unique data about the high latitude of southern regions of the moon.
And do you believe, sir, that this ambitious moon mission is, in a sense, going to be a stepping stone for India actually setting up its own space station, which is another very ambitious project, and then perhaps also landing a crew on the moon?
Yes, I told on time and again, many forums I am telling, we advocate the possibility of not only space station, a lunar space station. Because you know, the existing International Space Station is getting old and it needs to be replaced. When replacing, why can't, instead of replicating the same or duplicating the same thing in the near Earth, why can't make a habitat type of station and the moon itself? That means the International Lunar Space Station is the one which you target. When that happens, it's going to happen near the south high latitudes in the poles, and most probably the regions what Chandrayaan 2 is going to land. So that way, it's going to be a stepping stone for the possible, the eventual international lunar space station and the moon. When we talk about the lunar space station, a man definitely part and parcel of that. So that means eventually, when we talk about the whole globe is now talking about, especially advanced nations, going back to the moon. That means in 60s and 70s, people have gone to the moon. Now, they're looking in a totally different way. for the longer stay, the human concern, and even the you talk about even the tourism to the moon, very many vessels are being talked about here. When that happens, definitely this particular mission, its initial steps will be a really milestone, not only for India, the whole globe.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.